We are very proud to have, happy to have Pat Layton on the program. She's founder and president of Life Impact Network. Also, Surrendering the Secret, which is a post-abortion recovery ministry, and the author of a book called A Surrendered Life. Pat, welcome to the program, and that sounds like plenty to keep you busy.
Thank you very much. I'm honored to be here. And yes, I stay pretty busy.
Tell us about, first of all, before we get into your personal testimony, tell us what the Life Impact Network is.
Life Impact Network is actually the local crisis pregnancy center ministry that I started here in Tampa. We're 25 years old, and it was started as a result of my ministry with post-abortion recovery. Our pregnancy center is about the age of some of the earliest founded pregnancy centers in the nation. So it was kind of a new wave of ministry and Christian alternative to abortion that started all those years ago, and we jumped on that bandwagon and started a ministry that's a crisis pregnancy center. It now incorporates adoption, Christian adoption, as well as, of course, Surrendering the Secret post-abortion recovery. So we've become a national ministry, focused also on ministry to our local community.
Well, Pat, tell us a little bit about your story, because that is part of what has driven you inspired, but that is part of what has motivated you to spend the last 25 years helping women deal with the emotional and spiritual as well as physical results of the abortions that they've had.
That's right. The Bible says in Revelation that Revelation 12:11 says we overcome the enemy by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony. And my case is very much follows that path. I had an abortion when I was 23. I was an abortion advocate during my college years. I was very pro-choice. I was very vocal about my opinion about a woman's right to choose abortion. And I wrote articles and, carried pickets on my college campus. And so when I discovered myself to be pregnant with an unplanned pregnancy, my first response was abortion. And it was actually, it seemed to be the logical and the obvious thing for me to do at the time. So little did I know what I was spending my life into, which was basically 7 years of self-destruction. And so the result of that horrible journey that I took after my abortion led me to the Lord. So that was the awesome part of the story. And I surrendered my life to Christ. And at that time, I did that in 1984. And when I surrendered my life, I surrendered my story. And so I've been working with women who've had past abortions, educating the church, training the church about post-abortion recovery since then.
Well, we're talking to Pat Layton, who's founder and president of Life Impact Network. What is your this Surrendering the Secret? What is that exactly?
Surrendering the Secret is a Bible study. It was published by Lifeway and released in 2008. It's a beautiful Bible study that incorporates a video. It's an 8-part study that takes women through the healing process. It's actually used by men and couples as well. Leads them through the healing process with a video component that has a group of women sharing their stories of healing and restoration. So, Surrendering the Secret is designed specifically for men and women, designed specifically for the church to be used as a healing tool, within the church.
Pat, let me ask you to kind of walk us through what happened. In terms of your testimony, I think it's fascinating that you, approach the issue of abortion from a feminist perspective or whatever the ideology that, the prism through which you viewed this issue. And it's always interesting to me when the real world you know, run smack into someone's ideology, because your beliefs led you to think that abortion would be no big deal. It's just a blob of tissue, et cetera, et cetera. It's no different than having your appendix taken out or your tonsils. And so walk us through, was it simply your coming to Christ, or were there emotional things that began to transpire after you had an abortion? Kind of help us to peel away the layers of what was going on in your life when your real world, you know, intersected with your ideology.
Mm-hmm. That is such a wonderful question.
I was going to ask it, Pat, but Ed beat me to it.
It's a great truth, and it is truth, because I was very convinced, very brainwashed, as many college students and Americans are today, about abortion, and it sounds so enlightened and so right to offer women, you know, the right to their own body and the right to bring a child into a wanted home, and it all sounds so good. But for me, and I went into it with that perspective. I mean, I was told by my doctor I would go into, first of all, I walked into an abortion clinic, and I decided this place is so nasty and horrible, I'm not going to have an abortion here. And I fought for abortion, and I'm going to have a nice abortion. And so I went to my local GYN. I went into a very nice women's hospital for my abortion. I was told that I would be in the morning and out by lunchtime, and I would go on with my life. And that was exactly what I anticipated. But I woke up with a respirator tube stuck down my throat because I had had an allergic reaction to the anesthesia that they used during my abortion procedure. So, you know, when I look back on that, of course, I praise God, knowing that He protected me. If I'd have had that abortion in one of those clinics, I would probably not be on this conversation today. So I had an allergic reaction. I woke up from the abortion with my parents in the room. It was a horrible experience of shame and confusion, because when you're so convinced that you're doing the right thing and then your first emotion is shame, that immediately brings confusion into the situation. So things got worse, and they later told me that because of the emergency procedure and having to be put on the respirator during the abortion, the doctors announced to me that parts of the fetus had been left behind. Mm-hmm. And that I was going to have the abortion over again. So here I was, a young woman who had been very convinced of all the, you know, through all the rhetoric and all the, you know, the pitches that I had received about a woman's right to choose abortion, when all of a sudden, for the very first time in all those years, I was encountered with the reality that I had ripped apart and destroyed a life so badly that parts were left behind.
So it wasn't just a blob of tissue. This is
right.
This is a human being with arms and legs. And
that's exactly the memory, the thoughts that went with me from that hospital. I began immediately, in a very unplanned way, to think about the parts that might have been left behind. And I began to realize that I had destroyed a life. And, you know, as ridiculous it might sound, that was never on my mind during all my selling and all my writing and all my picketing. And I honestly believe that, you know, the word of God says that, you know, the enemy comes as an angel of light, and, you know, we have this shield over our eyes and our ears and our brains that that don't allow us to think about those parts. So when I was confronted with all that is when I began to fall apart and experience all the things that are talked about in post-abortion trauma. So those things started to take place in my life, every one of them. In my book, In Surrendering the Secret, we have a checklist. We have a post-abortion checklist, and we have a list of some of the behaviors or symptoms that you may have encountered after an abortion. And I make an A-plus 100% on that checklist. So that's what happened. After the abortion, after that trauma, I began to live out the shame and the loss and the heartbreak and the anger and the realities of what abortion really is, and which led me then to the Lord. That heartbreak and that life breakdown is what led me to the Lord, and I began to unfold what His Word says about abortion and about life.
We're talking to Pat Layton, L-A-Y-T-O-N, from Florida. She is with the she's founder and president of Life Impact Network. If you want to check out the Surrendering the Secret website, it's called, it's just surrenderingthesecret.com, surrenderingthesecret.com. What's there, Pat? What's available?
Well, we have a wonderful website that Surrendering the Secret has, as I said, was published by Lifeway. We've been out in the community. Before Lifeway published Surrendering the Secret, I pretty much used it in my local ministry and to train other pregnancy centers on how to reach women who've had past abortions. But when Lifeway published Surrendering the Secret, it became more focused on the church and training the church. So we now have over 1,000 leaders in churches all over the nation who have been trained to use Surrendering the Secret. So on the website, you find a beautiful interactive map that shows how to find those leaders. It will also show if we don't have a leader in your area and that we need your listeners to call me and to connect with us, and we will come and train in churches and communities anywhere that where we're invited. So we have on the website, we have information about how to connect with someone to help you through the study if you're someone who needs ministry. And we have information about how to come to one of our events to be trained to lead. We have all kinds of resources and information about the book. We have a list of our national training team. And, you know, so just lots of good resources and information about how to get help.